Yanai Tadashi is a Japanese billionaire businessman, the founder and president of fast retailing, the parent company of Uniqlo, a shortened version of the phrase unique clothing. As of when this video was made, was the richest person in all of Japan, with an estimated net worth of $42 billion. Yanai Tadashi is the 34th wealthiest person in the world, according to Bloomberg Billionaires Index. What's barely known about him is that he is of burakumin heritage, a caste once regarded as non-human during feudal Japan. The burakumin is a formal untouchable group in Japan, at the bottom of the traditional social hierarchy. Despite being of ethnic Japanese origin, they were classified as less, and in some cases a different race altogether. There were people with occupations seen as kegari, which means defilement in Japanese, during Japan's feudal era. Such occupations did include executioners, undertakers, slaughterhouse workers, butchers or tanners. Burakumin became a hereditary status of untouchability and an unofficial caste in the Tokugawa class system during the Edo period. Burakumin were victims of severe discrimination and ostracism in Japanese society and lived as outcasts in their own separate villages or ghettos. Burakumin status was officially abolished after the Meiji Restoration in 1868, but the descendants of burakumin have since continued to face stigmatization and discrimination in Japan. Yanai Tadashi, being born on 7th of February 1949 and growing mostly in the 50s and 60s, wasn't spared from anti-burakumin sentiment. Not so long ago, in 2001, the future Prime Minister of Japan, Taro Aso, along with Hiromu Nonaka, was among the LDP's chief candidates to succeed Yoshihiro Mori as Prime Minister of Japan. During a meeting of LDP leaders at which Nonaka was not present, Aso reportedly told the assembled group, "We are not going to let someone from the Buraku become the Prime Minister, are we?" Nonaka subsequently withdrew as a candidate. Aso's comment about Nonaka's heritage was revealed in 2005. Aso denied that he had made the statement, but Hisaoki Kamei, who was present at the 2001 meeting, stated in January 2009 that he had heard Aso say something to that effect. Despite the stigma associated with being burakumin, Tadashi was able to rise above it and build a business empire that rose to dominate the clothing industry in Japan and Asia. Yanai was born in Ube, Yamaguchi in southern Japan in February of 1949. He attended Ube High School and later Waseda University, graduating in 1971 with a bachelor's degree in economics and political science. In 1971, after graduating from college, Yanai started in business by selling kitchenware and men's clothing at Jusco Supermarket, a big supermarket chain in Japan, while traveling the world and picking up ideas. In an interview with ABS-CBN, he said, "My preference was not to work my entire life. That's how I was. My father demanded that I need to find work at Jusco, so regretfully I got a job." He quit after 1 year and started working for his father. Yanai's father owned a men's clothing shop called Ogori Choji. The store was on the first floor and the family lived above it. He said he joined his father's business because he had nowhere else to go, but he actually ended up finding it fun. By the 1970s, the business had several locations. In 1984 in Hiroshima, Yanai founded Unique Clothing Warehouse, which would later be shortened to Uniqlo. A few years later, he changed the name of his father's clothing company to Fast Retailing. The company grew very quickly over the next several years. By 1996, Yanai had more than 200 stores across Japan. Uniqlo, Fast Retailing's most successful brand, has more than 1,900 stores globally, with 810 of them in Japan. Only 50 of those are in the US, and the vast majority are scattered throughout Asian countries that include Japan, China, Hong Kong, and South Korea. Fast Retailing is the parent company of Uniqlo and other brands including Fiori, Comte des Conteneurs, and J-Brand. Fast Retailing has thousands of stores worldwide and reported annual revenue of about $20.8 billion in August of 2019. Fast Retailing is now the third largest global clothing retailer after H&M and Inditex, the parent company of Zara, according to Moneyweek. Yanai himself told Vault magazine in 2011, saying Uniqlo's clothing are geared to all types of people, whether they are billionaires, the middle class and the lower end. We need to cater to all, just like Marks & Spencer or Gap or the current H&M and Zara. Unless we cater to all segments of life and segments of people, we cannot be successful. Yanai has made it clear he wants Fast Retailing to be the world's largest clothing retailer. Yanai has always named H&M and Zara as Fast Retailing's biggest rivals. He told Forbes Asia in 2017 that his goal is to have the company's revenue up to $29 billion by 2020. Information and digital innovation will determine the winner, Yanai said, and that's the area we are in. Uniqlo opened its first stores in Denmark, Italy, India and Vietnam in 2019. Uniqlo has pioneered the use of artificial intelligence in its stores to improve customer shopping experience. Select stores have AI-powered U-mode kiosks that show customers a variety of products and measures their reactions to the color and style through neurotransmitters. Blake Morgan wrote in Forbes, based on each person's reaction, the kiosk then recommends products. Customers don't even have to push a button. Their brain signals are enough for the system to know how they feel about each item. And in 2018, Uniqlo launched GU-style studio stores, fitting only stores where customers can try on clothing and place orders online for later delivery, according to Japan Times. Yanai's two sons are both on Fast Retailing's board of directors. This means that corporate governance will function even when I'm absent, Yanai said when he announced their promotions in October of 2018. It does not mean that they will take charge of the company. Yanai's sons Kazumi Yanai and Koji Yanai were both senior vice presidents of Fast Retailing before being promoted to the board, according to Nikkei Asian Review. Yanai was also an influential member of the board of Japanese holding company SoftBank for 18 years. As business insider Isobel Asia Hamilton previously reported, Yanai had a reputation for being one of the few people with as much influence as SoftBank CEO Masayoshi Son. But in December 2019, SoftBank announced that Yanai will be resigning from the board at the end of the year to focus on his fashion business. In 2017, Yanai told Nikkei Asian Review that he will step down as president of Fast Retailing when he turned 70, but stay on as chairman. Yanai turned 72 in February of 2022 and so far has made no official announcement about leaving his role as president or about who will take his place, although he did recently tell Bloomberg Japan that his CEO role is more suitable for a woman because women are preserved, detail-oriented and have an aesthetic sense. Uniqlo Japan's female CEO, Maki Aki, has been tapped as potential successor to Yanai, Forbes recently reported. With that being said, if you have any requests, suggestions or questions, please don't fail to mention it in the comment section below. And remember, in all awesomeness, you keep being you. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share.